Yeah. Purport by His Divine Grace, A.C. Bhaktivedanta Swami Srila Prabhupada. Bijam means seat. Krishna is the seat of everything. There are various living entities, movable and inert, birds, beasts, men, and many other living creatures are moving living entities. Roses and plants, however, are inert. These cannot move, but only stand every entity is contained within the scope of 8,400,000 species of life. Some of them are moving and some of them are inert. In all cases, however, the seed of their life is Krishna. As stated in Vedic literature, Brahman, or the Supreme Absolute Truth, is that from which everything is emanating. Krishna is Parabrahman, the Supreme Spirit. Brahman is impersonal, and Parabrahman is personal. Impersonal Brahman is situated in the personal aspect, that is stated in Bhagavad Gita. Therefore, originally Krishna is the source of everything. He is the root. As the root of a tree maintains the whole tree, Krishna, being the original root of all things, maintains everything in this material manifestation. This is also confirmed in Vedic literature, Katha Upanishad, Nityo Nityanam Chetanas Chetananam Eko Bahunam Yovedati Kaman. He is the prime eternal among all eternals. He is the supreme living entity of all living entities, and he alone is maintaining all life. One cannot do anything without intelligence. And Krishna also says that he is the root of all intelligence. Unless a person is intelligent, he cannot understand the Supreme Personality of Godhead, Krishna.
要旨是由圣人A.C.Bhaktivedanta所解释，在梵文中的Bijam的意思是种子， Krishna 是万物的种子， 各种各样的生物体可以分成能动的和不能动的， 人类、飞禽、走兽和许多生物体都是能动的生物体， 花草树木则是不能动的生物体， 只能站立而不能移动。 生物共有840万种， 一些是能动的， 一些是不能动的， 但一切生命的种子都是 Krishna。 根据雷达文献的记载， 至尊绝对真理范是万物的源头， Krishna是至尊范， Parabrahman 是至尊的灵魂。 范不具人格特质， 而至尊范具有人格特性。 国家范歌中声明， 绝对真理的人格特性中已经包含了非人格特性的范， 因此从根本上说， Krishna是万物的源头， 是根， 树根滋养， 支撑的树， Krishna是万物的种， 种根， 维系的物质展示中的一切。 北达文献 卡塔奥义书中的第二篇第二章的第十三节是确认说， Nityonityanam Chetas Chetanas Chetanam Eko Bhagunam Yo Vidadati Kaman， 它是永恒中最主要的永恒， 生物中至尊的生物， 它独自维系着所有的生命， 没有智力就做不了任何事。 而Krishna说他还是一切智力的源头， 没有智力就不能了解至尊人格守神 Krishna。
Om Magyana Timarandasya Yajnantana Shakaya Chashurumitam Jena Asmai Shri Gurve Namaha Shri Chaitanya Manobhistam Sthapitam Yena Bhutale Swayam Rupa Katam Mayam Dadati Svapadantikam Vandeham Shri Guru Shri Yatha Paramalam Shri Guru Vaishnavamsya Shri Rupa Sakrajatam Sahagana Pradhanatam Vikam Tam Sajevam Sadhaitam Sabadutam Parijana Saitam Krishna Chaitanya Devam Shri Radha Krishna Padan Sahagana Lalita Shri Vishakha Nitamsya Hey Krishna Karuna Sindhu Dhinabandhu Jagatpate Gopi His opulences, or what is called his vibhutis. So Lord Krishna is explaining how he is the seed of all living entities. Everything is coming from him.
所以Krishna告诉我们呢，我们应该怎么样来看到所有生物都是由它而来的。
Everything must have a source. Where does it come from? We want to know where does it come from.
所以一切一定有的源头，而想说，这源头是从哪里来的？
But problem comes when you come to Krishna. You want to know where does Krishna come from.
问题是说。 那么Krishna从哪里来? Krishna是从什么地方来的呢?
We have to understand that Lord Krishna is the origin of all origins. Everything is coming from him.
我们必须要了解Krishna是一切源头的源头，所以一切都起源于他。
And this was described by Lord Brahma, who is the first living entity in the creation.
这由主 Brahma 梵天波罗恶魔所描述，他是宇宙的第一个生物，他这样描述的。Lord
Brahma also has his origin coming from the navel, from the lotus flower, which is born from the navel of Garbhodakshayi Vishnu.
Brahma 梵天他也有源头，他是从这个。 孕蛋之羊尾狮牛肚脐长出来的莲花生出来的。
And Lord Vishnu comes from Lord Krishna. Lord Krishna is the original supreme personality of Godhead.
然后Vishnu呢是从Krishna而来的。 Krishna是一切的源头，是至尊人格首神。
The example is given that the heat and light in one candle will be the same as the heat and light from other candles. But still there's one original candle which lights the other candles. Lord Krishna is that original candle. One time there was a discussion between the great sages. They were considering who is actually the supreme between Brahma, Vishnu, and Shiva.
曾经有一次，这个圣人们聚集在争论，就是说，到底谁是至尊呢？是Brahma啦、Shiva啦，还是Vishnu？
Sometimes people think all the gods are the same.
有些时候人们认为所有的神都一样的。
So there was discussion between the sages, who is actually the supreme?
所以在圣哲们中就在讨论说谁是原始。
So at that time, one of the sons of Lord Brahma, Bhrigu Muni, was given the task to go and test Brahma, Vishnu, and Shiva and find out who is actually the supreme.
有一次呢，Brahma 的孩子呢 ，Brigmuni 就说呢，去外面做一项工作，去测试一下谁是至尊主。
So Brigmuni went to see first of he went to Kailash to see Lord Shiva and his abode. Lord Shiva is like a brother of Brigmuni.
所以呢，这个Brigmuni 就去到 Kailash 这个山呢去看 Shiva 啊。
He went to see Lord Shiva, and Lord Shiva saw his brother Brigmuni coming, and he was happy. He thought, "My dear brother," and Lord Shiva came forward to embrace Brigmuni.
然后就是说看到 Shiva， Shiva 很高兴，就是说，我亲爱的兄弟啊 ，Brigmuni， 你什么原因来到我这里呢
？But Brigmuni said to Shiva, "Oh, don't you touch me. Your body is all covered with ashes, and you've got these snakes on your body. You don't touch me."
那 Brigmuni 就跟 Shiva 说："你不要碰我。你呢，这身上这么脏呢，你满身黑乌乌的，然后又被那些鬼魂呐、那个坟墓的死灰碰触呢，你太脏了，不要碰我。
"So Lord Shiva is one of his names is Asutosh.Meaning, he's easily pleased, but he's also easily angered.
那 Shiva 呢有一个名字叫 Ashutosh， 就是说他是很容易被取悦的，而且很容易愤怒。
So when he heard these words from Brigmuni, he was upset. He became very angry at him, and he went to get his trident. He was going to kill Brigmuni.
那 Shiva 听到这样子，他 Brigmuni 这么说，他非常的愤怒，他去把他的三叉戟拿过来，要把他这样刺过去。
So it was only when Mother Parvati came and helped restrain her husband, she pleaded with Brigmuni, "You better get out of here quick to save your life."
所以这个这个 Shiva 的老婆呢 ，Parvati 就赶快出来制止这个。Brigmuni， 然后就说你最好赶快逃，赶快走了，不要让他愤怒了，去杀了你这些事。
So Brigmuni departed from Kailash and he went to Satyaloka, the planet where Lord Brahma resides at the top of the universe.
所以 Brigmuni 就从 Kailash 这山区离开了，然后去到这个Satyaloka 那个星球呢，是 Brahma 半天住的星球。
And Brigu came before Lord Brahma. He did not offer any respects, but actually Lord Brahma is his father, and he should have shown some respect to his father. But Brigu didn't offer any respects.
Brigmuni 呢，他来到 Brahma 的面前呢，没有去跟他顶拜。实际上 ，Brahma 梵天呢是他的父亲，他是应该见到他，应该给他做一个致敬礼。
So Brahma saw Brigmuni like this. He was certainly not pleased with his son. He controlled himself, however, but Brigu could understand there was some tension there in the meeting. Brahma was not satisfied with the reception given by Brigu.
Brahma 当然很不高兴，有点生气，可是他控制自己这个怒火。可是呢 ，Brigmuni 感觉他们两个之间有一点紧张哈，他感觉气氛有点紧张，所以他有点注意了。
So Lord Brahma controlled his anger, but he was not pleased with Brigmuni, and Brigmuni could understand that Brahma wasn't very happy with him.
那 Brahma 呢控制自己的这个愤怒呢，那 Brigmuni 呢，他可以感觉到 Brahma 对他不高兴，有一些东西啊，生气或什么东西在里面。
So then, Brigmuni left that place, left Brahma's abode, and he then went to see Lord Vishnu, who resides in Sri Tadweep. And he went to see Lord Vishnu and found Lord Vishnu laying.On his bed, with his feet being massaged by the goddess of fortune, Lakshmi.
So Brigmuni 就离开了 Satya 星球，然后去到这个 Sri Tadweep 去找 Vishnu， 那 Vishnu 正躺在那里呢，由这个性女神在对他做按摩。
So Brihamani came forward to see Lord Vishnu, and he just simply kicked him on the chest.
那 Brihamani 走到这个 Vishnu 面前，就一脚踢到这个 Vishnu 的胸膛。
If you get a deity of Lord Vishnu, you'll see the footprint of Brihamani on the chest of Lord Vishnu.
所以，如果你有机会得到这个 Vishnu 的神像的话，你会看到 Vishnu 的这个神像的这个形体胸膛有一个脚印是 Brihamani 踢他的。
So how did Lord Vishnu respond to this? Lord Vishnu calmly got up from his resting position, and he said to Brihamani, "Oh, my dear Brihamani, I hope you have not hurt your foot on my hard chest."
那么啊，这个 Vishnu 怎么反应呢？啊 ，Vishnu 就很平静的站起来啊，从休息的姿态中站起来，对 Brihamani 说：“哎呀 ，Brihamani 啊，你怎么来了啊？”你踢了我一脚，我希望你的脚没有受到我的胸膛坚硬的胸膛而受伤。
So Lord Vishnu was happy to hear these words from. Brihamani was very happy to hear Lord Vishnu speaking this way. He could understand the exalted position of Lord Vishnu.
啊，所以 Brihamani 呢，听到 Vishnu 讲的这番话，感觉非常高兴。那他可以明白呢，Vishnu 的这种崇高的地位。
He had offended Lord Brahma by his actions.
他是由他的行动去冒犯了 Brahma， 犯天。
And he offended Lord Shiva by his words.
他在他的言语上呢，去冒犯了 Shiva。
But his offense against Lord Vishnu was the greatest. He used physical violence against Lord Vishnu.
但是他去冒犯的 Vishnu 是最大的冒犯，他是在行动上直接去触犯他。
But Lord Vishnu did not take any offense against him.
但是 Vishnu 没有对他的冒犯做任何的。
However, it is said that Lakshmi, the goddess of fortune, she's the consort of Lord Vishnu. She was offended.
这么说呢，就是说啊 ，Vishnu 的伴侣呢，性女神反而觉得被冒犯。
And ever since that time, the Brahmanas have not received any mercy from the goddess of fortune.
从那个之后。婆罗门就没有得到幸运女神的仁慈或祝福。
Of course, that's a blessing for the Brahmanas that they can live simply. They don't need wealth.
这没有幸运女神的祝福，就是没有财富。但是对婆罗门来说，这是不太重要，因为婆罗门对财富没有那么重视。
The Brahmanas have their own wealth and their austerities.
婆罗门有他们自己的财富，就是他们的苦行。
So we should understand the exalted position of Lord Krishna.
所以我们必须要来了解 Krishna 的杰出的地位。
How everything is actually coming from him. He is the seed of all living entities.
来了解呢，所有一切都是由 Krishna 而起源的啊，它是所有万物的种子。
Later on in Bhagavad Gita, Lord Krishna says, "Aham bija pradapitaha, I am the seed-giving father of all living entities."
我在瓦坎后面有说到 ，Aham bija pradapitaha， 就是说我是所有生物的父亲，所有生物的种子。
And Srila Prabhupada in the purport explains how there are many different kinds of living entities. The Vedas describe how there are 8,400,000 different species of life.
那后来巴巴也告诉我们，就是说在伟大经典描述了在世界上的生物有840万种类的生物。
We have many different creatures living in the sea, in the ocean, the aquatic creatures.
啊，有很多的生物也住在这个海洋啦，水族类的这些生物也很多种类。
You have many different trees and plants of all varieties.
植物方面也有很多各种的各类的这些树木等等。
Now then you have the animals and birds and insects.
啊，动物啦，这个鸟类啦，这个昆虫类等等。
And we have, of course, the human species of life.
啊，当然还有人类。
And so some species are moving, and like the human species, the different animals and birds and so on, they're all moving, but there's also species which are fixed, as Prabhupada explained, the trees, the plants, they're fixed in the ground, they don't move.
在生物中呢，有一些是活动的，有一些是固定的，会动的，就像人类啦，各种动物啦。那包括也告诉我们，有一些生物不动的，就像树木、花草那种固定生长的。
So there's different consciousness levels of consciousness in different living entities.
所以在不同类的生物里面有不同的知觉程度。
The most important form of life.Is to have the human form of life, because in the human form of life, we are given intelligence.
那么在这么多种生物的身体里面，得到人类的生命呢，是最重要的。
And Lord Krishna goes on to say that he is the source of the intelligence.
那 Krishna 也继续说呢 ，Krishna 他自己是所有的智力的源头。
In the Bhagavad Gita, in 15th chapter, Lord Krishna describes how he is situated in the heart of everyone, and from him comes knowledge, remembrance, and forgetfulness.
在后面呢，佛教梵歌第十四章，菩萨也说到，所有的知识、所有的记忆、所有的遗忘，都是由他而来的。
So Lord Krishna is giving knowledge.But everything according to the qualification, according to what people deserve.
所以 Krishna 是给予生物知识的，但是呢，那也根据所有的生物他们的资格所可应得的资格。
We see some people are blessed with very high levels of intelligence.
我们看到有一些人，被获予。很高的智力。
They can study all kinds of complex teachings and philosophies, and they can absorb it all.
而且啊，这种高智力的人呢，他们可以去学习研究很复杂的学科，而且可以记下来。
So this intelligence, this is actually the blessing coming from the Lord Himself.
所以这些智力、智性呢，是由于主他本人所给予、所祝福的。
And at any moment, that intelligence can be taken away from us.
但是呢，在任何时刻，这个智力也有可能被收回去。
Everything can be completely lost.
任何时刻，所有一切都可能都失落了。
Just like during the battle of Kurukshetra.There was often situations where Arjuna's life was in danger.
就像在这个库鲁之野的战事里面，在任何时刻，阿朱那都处在危险之地。
Sometimes the different warriors were coming and challenging and fighting with Arjuna, and Arjuna's life was at risk when Grandfather Bhishma came before him.
那么很多。是呢，很多的士兵来到阿朱那面前，就是跟他对战挑战。那阿朱那生命处在危系旦夕呢，这个他的 Bhishma 他的爷爷过来了帮忙。
Bhishma vowed that he was going to kill Arjuna.
Bhishma 曾经发誓过，他要来把阿朱那杀掉。
When the moment came where Bhishma was coming to kill Arjuna, at that moment Lord Krishna came and saved the life of Arjuna.
然而呢，在这个 Bhishma 准备要杀 Arjuna 的时候 ，Krishna 当场出现来阻止啊 Bhishma 杀掉 Arjuna.
Now when Arjuna was fighting with Karna, then Karna got in difficulties.
那 Arjuna 来对 Karna 对战的时候，这个 Karna 就处在困境里。
And Kung's chariot got stuck. Kung. Yeah. Kung's chariot, Kung, his chariot got stuck. And he couldn't remember all the mantras to get the chariot free.
那个 Kung 就是指 Kung 啊 ，Kung 啊，当时就是说他的战车的轮子然后陷落了，所以车子动不了。
And that time Lord Krishna told Arjuna go kill him.
所以那个 Kung 在那个时候就在困境的时候，Krishna 叫 Arjuna 说，趁这个机会你去把这 Kung 去杀掉。
And Kung was pleading that, oh, it's not fair. Look, am I? We're not in the proper situation. We should be equal when we fight each other.
啊，在那个时候，那个卡纳就对阿朱那喊着说：“这样不公平，我们应该处在公平的这种情境里面才可以对决。”
But Lord Krishna told Arjuna, "Well, there was no mercy to Abhimanyu. Why should there be any mercy now?"
那 Krishna 对阿朱那说。当时他们对 Abhimanyu 也手下不留情，现在为什么要对 Kana 来留情呢？
So Lord Krishna is equal to everyone, but he has a special favor to his devotees.
当然 Krishna 是平等的对待众生，但是 Krishna 对于他的奉献者有一种特别的恩宠。
So he can give people intelligence, he can guide people how to properly act, and at the same time he can take away that ability.
Krishna 可以给人们呢智力啊很高的智力能力，但是任何时刻 ，Krishna 也可以把那人的智力跟能力收回去。
He gives knowledge, but he can also allow you to forget.
所以 Krishna 给人们智力，但是 Krishna 也有能力让有办法让你忘记。
And you can remember by the grace of Krishna.
所以一个人能够记得有记忆的话，是由于。
The forgetfulness is given by the grace of Krishna, so that we can enjoy the material world.
那么我们的遗忘也是 Krishna 的恩典，而让我们可以在物质世界里面去享乐。
We forget that there's everything is temporary, and we think only about the pleasure of this world.
我们的遗忘是忘记在这个世界所有一切都是短暂暂时的而认为这样子可以去享乐
If we have to remember how everything is temporary and how we're going to have to leave everything at some point then we cannot enjoy so well
如果我们会记得说所有的一切都是短暂暂时出现的话那我们怎么会去享受呢
So Lord Krishna takes away thatHe takes away these memories so that we can enjoy, we forget.
So Krishna 把我们的记忆拿走，让我们去遗忘，所以我们可以去享受。
And Lord Krishna is the prowess of all powerful men. That tejas, that power, that is also by the grace of Krishna, the grace of God.
And Krishna 也是所有的万能之能，他是所有能力的能力，所以他是最有力量的。
So devotee gives a credit to Krishna for everything.
所以奉献者把所有的一切功劳都归给 Krishna.
A devotee never considers himself to be the doer.
奉献者永远不会认为这个是自己的作为。
But he understands everything is the arrangement of Lord Krishna.
但是他了解所有的一切都是 Krishna 的安排。
And similarly, when we come to see Krishna, when we come to see the deities, we should actually think that we're coming to be seen by Krishna.
同样的道理，当我们来前来瞻仰神像、看神像的时候，我们应该去认为我们来被 Krishna 看。
We are not, but Krishna's not there as our servant.But we are coming to serve Krishna.
Krishna 不是坐在那里是我们的仆人，而是我们来服务 Krishna.
So we come before Krishna in that mood to be seen by him.
所以我们呢，以服务的心态来到 Krishna 面前，来被 Krishna 看到。
There's a story how one blind man was asking his friend, "Please take me to the temple."
有一个故事是这样，曾经有一个瞎子，一个盲人，他告诉人家说：“请你带我去到庙里。”
And his friend was saying, why you want to go to the temple? You're blind, you can't see anything.
他的朋友说，你干嘛去庙里？你这个瞎子，你什么都看不到，你去庙里干嘛？
But the man said, no, I may be blind, but I want Krishna to see me, so I want you to take me to the temple.
这个人就说，对呀，我是瞎子没有错，可是我想你带我去到庙里，我让 Krishna 看到我，我被 Krishna 看了。
So that is the proper mood as we come in the temple before Krishna. We come to see the, we come not to be, not for us to see the Lord, but to, for us to be seen by the Lord.
所以这是恰当的态度，不是我们来看主，而是我们来被主看。
He is the master, and we are the servant.
他是主人，我们是仆人。
Srila Prabhupada quotes this very important verse from the Vedas, from one of the Upanishads, which is Nityo Nityanam Chaitanas Chaitananam. Very important, very meaningful sloka from the Vedas.
Srila Prabhupada 曾经就引述了在伟达经典的奥义书里面有一段诗节非常重要的诗节。
There are a class of people who don't accept Bhagavad Gita. They're called maybe Vedantists or Jnanis. They will accept only the Vedas, only the Shruti, not the Smriti.
那个有一类人呢，他们接受这伟达经典啊，但是他们不接受国家梵歌，他们那一些人称为 Vedantis， 就是维达经的学者，他们只接受那一些圣训经典写撰出来的经典，而不接受那从传承传递下来从聆听得到的这种神训经典。
Yeah, Shruti means the hearing process, so it refers to the four Vedas.
Shruti 就是神训经典，就是 Shruti 就是聆听的意思，就是说聆从聆听而获得的伟大知识。
And from Srimad Bhagavatam, we know that the Vedas was knowledge imparted into the heart of Brahma. Tene Brahma Hridaya Adikavaye Muyanti Yatsurana. That the Vedic knowledge was imparted into the heart of Lord Brahma at the beginning of the creation.
所以呢，我们知道呢，这个佛教瓦坛呢，是从 Brahma 那边 ，Brahma 是他的知识是由 Krishna 把这个知识传授到，就是说聆听而进到 Brahma 的心里面。
So there's a class of people who will say, I only accept the Vedas, only the four Vedas.You want it, and if you quote Srimad Bhagavatam or Bhagavad Gita, they will say, no, 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 that's Smriti, that's just coming from a mundane person, it's not coming from God, it's not divine.
So, 那一类人呢，就是说接受伟达经典那四部伟达的人呢，他们不接受那个神训经典聆听而来，他们说你们国家梵歌、国家瓦坛只是从随便的人那边说出来、写出来的，所以我们不接受。
So sometimes we do have to quote from the Vedas.
所以有些时候我们是要来从伟达经典去引述一些叙述或诗节。
If we try to establish the supreme position of Lord Krishna, just quoting the Bhagavad Gita, not everyone will accept.
因为呢，有时候我们只是从国家梵歌引述 Krishna 的叙述的话，不是每个人都接受的。
But if you quote a Vedic verse, then they cannot argue with that.
但是如果我们把这伟达经典的诗节引述出来的话，那些人就没办法跟来争论了。
So the Vedic verse is Nityo Nityanam. Amongst all eternals, there is one supreme eternal being.
所以你就你就那么就是说，在无数的永恒的存在事物里面，有一个至尊永恒。
And Chaitananas Chaitananam, amongst all conscious beings, there is one supremely conscious person.
Chaitananam, Chaitananam， 就是说在无数的生物中有一位至尊生物。
This is a very powerful verse to support the personal aspect of the Supreme Godhead.
这一段，这两句的诗节是一个伟大经典里面很强有力的引述，来支持国家梵歌至尊主的地位。
And then the verse goes, Eko Bahunam Yovadati Kama, that one Supreme Lord providing the needs of everyone.
而且再来就 Eko Bahunam， 就是说在那么多生物，这位至尊生物他提供所有万物的一切需要。
So from the Vedas we can establish also that there is one Supreme Being over everyone.
所以从伟大经典我们也可以看到呢，就是说有诗节来支持这些叙述，就是说存在中有至尊生物，而且他提供万物支持万物。
And Lord Krishna himself will say in a couple of verses, he will say, there is no truth superior to me.
然后Krishna在《国家梵歌》里面也说到，就是说，再没有其他的真理高于我。
No one else ever said like that. Lord Shiva never said that. Lord Brahma never says that. We never hear it from any other personality. Only Lord Krishna himself said, there is no truth superior to me.
没有其他的人，没有其他的生物可以像 Krishna 这么说，除了我之外，没有其他的生物高于我。Shiva 啦， Brahma 啦，他们都也没有这么说，也不敢这么说。
And when we hear the different pastimes of Lord Krishna, then we hear how all the different devas, how they are all subordinate to the position of Lord Krishna.
当我们在聆听的 Krishna 的逍遥时光呢，从这伟大经典里面听到呢，就说很多的这些 deva 半神人们呢，都在协助着 Krishna 的这一些活动逍遥时光。
Lord Krishna is always God. He didn't become God.
Krishna 是总是神，他不是说他什么时候变成神。
And even as a tiny child, only a few months old, he was able to take the life of Putana.
即便 Krishna 只是一个婴儿的时候，才几个月大，他都可以把 Putana 的生命拿起来，让他没气了。
And that Putana, she was coming from an interesting family. She's this, a whole Bucky Yam Stanat Kala Kutam. A whole Bucky, she's the sister of another demon who Lord Krishna also killed, Bakasura.
那么这个 Putana 这个女魔，她是另外一个女魔的姐妹，就是说 Bakasura 这一只恶魔的姐妹，那也是被 Krishna 杀掉的。
An interesting family, Bakasura, and Bakasura had a brother, Agasura.
这是一个很有趣的恶魔家族 ，Bakasura， 他有一个兄弟 Agasura， 这个恶魔。
Aga means sin. Yes, it's a personification of sin.
Aga 的意思是罪恶，就是说这个恶魔就是罪恶的这个。人格化。
And there's Putana, also Putana, the sister of these two brothers. You know?
那这个还有这个 Putana 是这两个恶魔的姐妹。
So Lord Krishna, even from the beginning of his life, he was liberating these demons from their.
所以 Krishna 在他出现的很早期的时候就来拯救这两个恶魔了。
And then later on, then Lord Krishna also purified the consciousness of devas like Indra, who was proud and who tried to annihilate, devastate Vrindavan by sending the clouds to destroy Vrindavan.
那之后呢 ，Krishna 也用来杀灭了很多，消除了很多恶魔，比方说这个 Indra 他想要来这个。用他的云呢来毁灭本达本，那 Krishna 也把他这些消弭他们这些恶魔的骄傲。
And you have Lord Brahma taking away the cows and the cowherd boys from Lord Krishna for a period of a year.
还有这个 Brahma 呢，他把 Krishna 的一些牧牛童跟牛呢，啊，带走藏起来就一年了。
Lord Krishna expand himself and take the place, take the place of all the calves and all the cowherd boys for 1 year.
那 Krishna 就必须把自己扩展，所有的这一些牧牛童跟牛，然后呢，要把他们这样复制，然后带回来。
And in this way, Lord Brahma learned his lesson. He wanted to understand the pastimes of Lord Krishna. So he was taught by Lord Krishna.
所以像这样的情况， Brahma 就得到了教训，就亲自由 Krishna 展示这样的情况呢，消弭他这种骄傲。
Then you have Varuna, one of the servants of Varuna arrested Krishna's father, Nanda Maharaj, and took him a prisoner. And Lord Krishna had to come and free him.
还有这个 Varuna 呢，他曾经呢去他去逮捕 Krishna 的爸爸南达大军，把他抓到监狱里面去， Krishna 就必须出来拯救。
Then you have Lord Krishna, that how he after be taking knowledge from his teacher Sandipani Muni asked Lord Krishna and Balaram to bring back his son from death.
然后还有呢，Krishna 也去求受教于 Sandipani Muni， 他跟他的哥哥 Balaram 一起那边求学呢。他的老师 Sandipani Muni 后来就叫 Krishna 把他的儿子让他死里复活。
And Krishna did. He did it. He brought back Sandipani Muni's son to him.
那Krishna做到了，把这个老师啊 ，Sandipani Muni 的儿子，让他起死回生。
And then Devaki was asked Krishna bring back his older brothers because 6 of his older brothers had all been killed by Kamsa, so Lord Krishna brought all them back from death also.
还有啊，像这个 Devaki 呢，他也请求 Krishna 呢，把他其他的兄弟呢，在战争里面被杀死，也请求他。把所有的兄弟让他们起死复活， Krishna 也让这些人呢起死复活。
One time Lord Shiva wanted to understand the nature of Lord Krishna's Maya. So at that time Lord Krishna took the form of Mohini Murti and bewildered the mind of Lord Shiva.
有一次呢， Shiva 也想知道 Krishna 他的 Maya 这个潜能的力量，那 Krishna 呢就展示出这个 Mohini Murti 呢，来困惑的这个 Shiva。
There are so many different ways Lord Krishna was displaying himself as the supreme personality of God。
所以 Krishna 呢，以很多的方式来展示出他是至尊人格守神。
And Srila Prabhupada says, you have to have a little intelligence to understand Krishna is God.
包括他说呢，人们必须要多少要一点智力，才能去了解 Krishna 是至尊神。
The understanding Lord Krishna is the supreme Lord, then it's only proper that we should surrender to Him, take up His, engage in His service.
那么了解 Krishna 是至尊主的恰当态度，就是说。我们了解他是至尊主，而且去向他臣服，而去服务。
And how to serve the Lord? What can we do in that way of service for Him? The most important thing which we can do for His service is to chant His holy name.
那怎么样来服务主呢？怎么样服务 Krishna 呢？最重要、最有力的方式就是来念诵 Krishna 的名字。
Everyone is therefore invited.To chant the holy name. You can chant anytime, any place, anyone can chant.
每个人呢，大家都邀请过来，在任何时候、任何地方都可以来念诵主的圣名。
There are no rules in chanting the holy name, so much.
在念诵 Krishna 的圣名呢，是没有任何硬性的规则。
People in any position, purified or unpurified,They can all chant the holy name.
人呢，在任何的境界、任何阶段，不管他已经进化或是没有进化呢，都可以来念诵主的圣名。
By chanting the holy name, we will purify the heart, and that purification of the heart will allow us to understand the position of Lord Krishna.
念诵着 Krishna 的圣名呢，会让我们得到净化，然后我们的心的净化呢，就可以来了解 Krishna 的地位。
So this opportunity is given to all of us. It's made very easy for us in this Kali Yuga.
所以啊，我们被给予了这样的方式，是这个在卡利年代一个很容易去进行的方式。
Although Kali Yuga is a bad time, it's made auspicious for us when we start to chant the holy name.
虽然呢，卡利年代是一个很糟糕的时候，但是呢，我们念诵主的圣名呢，就会变得是非常吉祥的。
Just simply by chanting the holy name, one can get all perfection.
仅仅只是通过念诵主的圣名呢，人都可以得到所有一切的完美。
So we encourage all of you, people kindly try to understand the importance of regularly chanting the holy name.
所以我们希望大家可以来了解规律的念诵主的圣名这样的必要跟重要。
And to help us improve the quality of our chanting, it's also beneficial if we will follow some principles like being a vegetarian.
然后呢，我们在念诵圣名呢，遵循生活的一些原则来规范，会帮助我们可以更好的念诵。比方说，成为素食者。
We may say, "Oh, is it important?" Yes, it is important.
人们可能会说，那重要吗？是的，是重要的。
The what we put into our mouth will affect our consciousness, our state of being.
我们放了什么样的东西进到我们的从嘴巴进去到我们身体，会影响我们身体的这个状态跟知觉。
So we know modern times people are very lazy about these things, and they don't follow very strictly.
我们知道在现代社会，人们也算很懒了，很难这么严格，但是呢，这原则很重要。
We encourage you. Think carefully. Try to do the good, the right thing.
所以我鼓励大家呢，很小心的去思考，然后很好的来遵循。
All right. Are there any questions?
各位有没有任何问题？
Hare Krishna, thank you so much for nice lecture. So I have a question regarding at the beginning of today's lecture you mentioned about Krishna gives according to our desire. So and then you mentioned that also Krishna is very merciful and he gives special benediction or special favor to his own devotee who is very near to him. So is the second one is apart from that desire or including the desire or
not? 他问最开始有提到呢 ，Krishna 会就是对他的奉献者有特别的恩宠仁慈，那这个是不是也是根据奉献者的愿望而去给予他们那些祝福？
Yeah, we have to understand. Lord Krishna understands everyone's heart. He can understand the mood of people. What is their actual desire?
是的，我们必须要了解 Krishna 在每一个人的心里面，他知道每一个人的心里的愿望，心里的状况。
So he's equal to everyone, as he describes himself in the Bhagavad Gita.
就如在国家梵歌里面说呢 ，Krishna 对所有的生物是平等的。
But he has a special interest in those who are his devotees.
而 Krishna 对于他的奉献者还有一种特别的兴趣。
When Krishna sees someone make an attempt to become a devotee, then Lord Krishna will try to help them to become a devotee.
那很想看到，如果有一个人有试图要努力成为奉献者，很想会帮忙那个人成为奉献者。
But if you see someone else not very concerned about it and what we might say apathetical about, doesn't make any attempt to try to become a devotee, and doesn't have, so it doesn't happen. Why should Krishna, if the individual doesn't care himself, then why should Krishna care?
那如果有一些人呢，只是说表面说说啦，对这个成为奉献者没有兴趣，那个人自己都没有兴趣，那 Krishna 为什么要去关心那个他没有兴趣的人
？Lord Krishna is not going to force you to take devotional service.
Krishna 不会去强迫你去接受奉献服务。
But at the same time, if you ask Lord Krishna to give you poison,then Lord Krishna will think, well, no, that's not very good.
但是如果同时你跟 Krishna 要求一些毒物或毒药啊， Krishna 还会认为说啊，那个其实对你不太好，那个不太好。
Yeah, we're thinking to, oh, Krishna, I really want, but Krishna knows this is something which is really bad for you. It's really like poison. Lord Krishna thinks, why should I give him that?
如果一个人要求的一些东西呢，可以想说啊，这个东西就像毒物、毒药，对你不好，啊，对那个人不好，我为什么要去给呢
？Lord Krishna is thinking of the welfare, is thinking of the good people.
嗯 ，Krishna 是在想的，一个就是说，对人们好的、有意义的事。
And when he sees someone just having a little bit of a desire, then Lord Krishna tries to help him, to encourage him in that path.
如果 Krishna 看到一个人，他即使有一点点愿望要成为奉献者， Krishna 会去帮助他，鼓励他。
But if we're not worried about it, then Krishna also doesn't worry about it.Okay, they're happy in the material world. Then let them stay in the material world.
那么如果那些人自己都不担心了啊，那 Krishna 说好吧，那就让他们留在那啦。他们想在物质世界，就让他们留在物质世界。
Take a few more 100 births in the material world.
就让他就在这个物质世界再投生数百回吧。
Different species of life, the wheel of birth and death.
让他们在经过不同种类的身体啊，来经历这些生生死死。
But when one genuinely wants to awaken a higher consciousness, he wants to come out of this existence of material conditioning, then Lord Krishna.
但是如果一个人是真正的想要脱离物质世界的制约，这个限制， Krishna 会真正帮他脱离这个物质的制约。
So he sees the qualification which everyone has. He can understand who is qualified, who has that desire.
所以 Krishna 去看每一个人的资格，他知道每一个人状况，谁是有什么样的资格，什么样程度的状态。
And when you desire, genuinely desire to get that higher things, then Krishna helps.
如果说你是真正有那样的愿望，是真正要有更高的这一些愿望，然后 Krishna 会来帮的。
One devotee used to talk about, he said that you have to want Krishna so badly that you will cry for Krishna.
曾经有个奉献者就是说。你真的要死命的去要 Krishna， 就是你都哭着死的，要死要活的，要到 Krishna 那样子。
So we're learning how to cry for Krishna. That we want Krishna so much.
我们在学着为 Krishna 而哭，就说我们是那么死命的要到 Krishna。
We always have the choice between Krishna and Maya.
我们是一直都有选择，我们是要 Krishna 呢，还是要 Maya？
So one is in the light, and one is in the dark.
就说一个在 光明里面，一个在黑暗里。
One is in the mode of passion and ignorance.
嗯，一个是在愚昧里面，在激情愚昧里。
And the other is transcendental.
啊，那另外一个是在超然的状态。
So we have to consider what we actually want.
嗯，所以我们必须要来去思虑，我们真正要的是什么。
So Krishna is there with us, he's guiding us, he's helping us.
所以是 Krishna 是在那儿等着我们，要帮我们，要救我们。
There's a famous book in English, it's called Alice in Wonderland.
有一本有名的这个英语的这个小童话故事，爱丽丝梦游仙境。
Young children like that.
那个爱丽丝去到各种境界，那个小
Tells about Alice going into the Wonderland.
爱丽丝去到各种仙境里。
And the first person she met, she asked him. She said, "Where do I go from here?"
那个爱丽丝进到一个地方的第一个人，她见到她说，我从这里可以去到哪里
？So he said, "Well, where do you want to go?"
那个人问他说：“你想去哪里？”
And she said, "Well, I don't really know."
那个爱丽丝说：“可是我真的不知道哎。”
So I said, "Then it doesn't matter which way you go, does it?"
那个人跟他说：“既然你不知道，那你去哪儿就没关系了。”
You have to know where you want to go.
所以你必须知道你想要去哪里。
Where do you want to go?
你想去哪里？
When you live up, when we leave this body, one day we're going to give up the body. Where do you want to go?
那当我们有一天要离开这个身体的时候，你到底要去哪里呀？
We have to be very clear and conscious about what destination we want to achieve.
所以我们必须要我们的知觉里面要非常清楚，我们要去到什么地点，什么目标。
You want to go to Krishna? You want to be with Krishna?
你想去 Krishna 那里吗？你想跟 Krishna 在一起吗？
You want to come back as a dog?
你想回来变成狗吗？
Or a tree?
或是变成树？
Or a fish?
或是成为鱼呀？
There are so many species.
有太多种这个生物的形体了。
So we have to be careful.
所以我们必须要去小心。
Make the best use of this human life.
在人类身体里面做最好的应用。
So Maharaj, the initiatives would be from our side during devotion. Otherwise, Krishna is not good.
Starting, we should have the desire to have devotion.
I know what he says. You translate.
Okay. The expression, so I'm not sure. Marsh 没有表情，所以确定。他问说：“这个是起点是我们必须想要有这个奉献奉爱。”
Yes, the initiative has to come from our side. We have to be very positive what we want.
所以这个起点是我们自己必须要有这样愿望，是正向的愿望。
We are given that free will.
我们被赋予这个自由意志。
Krishna or Maya?
我们是要 Krishna 或是 Maya?
One side of material energy or the spiritual energy?
我们要是灵性的能量或是物质的能量。
We have to be very clear, very fixed in our purpose.
所以我们必须要非常清楚，非常坚定在我们的这个目标宗旨里。
So Maharaj, is that true that when we gradually develop in progress in spiritual path, so Krishna takes away all the material things? Is that true?
他问说，当我们一个人在灵性的途径上前进的时候， Krishna 会把我们的障碍去除，是不是？
Yes, Krishna will help you to get over all the obstacles.
是的， Krishna 会帮你克服所有的障碍困难。
When you are genuine, when you seriously want to overcome these obstacles, then Krishna will take them all away.
所以如果你是真正的认真的想要去到 Krishna 那里，很认真的 Krishna 会帮助你克服那些障碍。
You just have to hold on to the holy name, chant the holy name.
就是要继续保持坚定的把握住念诵圣名。
And stay in the association of devotees.
然后留处于奉献者的联谊里。
You can overcome all the obstacles.
你这样可以来克服所有的障碍。
Prabhupada said, I will kick away all the obstacles.
Prabhupada 说我会在你们途径上的障碍把它剔除这些障碍。
Just take shelter of Krishna, surrender.
就来投奔 Krishna, 向 Krishna 臣服。
All the obstacles, what you think of obstacles, they just become insignificant in the association of Krishna consciousness.
所以在 Krishna 知觉里面的涟漪，那些障碍就变得微不足道了。
All these obstacles, they're just like bubbles in the ocean. There's so many bubbles formed in the waves in the sea. These bubbles have a very temporary existence. So these obstacles which you're talking about, they're also very temporary.
那所有的障碍都像在海洋的水里面的一些小泡泡。这些小泡泡呢，很快的就消除了，然后微不足道这样子的。
Probably you mentioned like we are human beings, so we have that intelligence to think about Krishna to do service. Let's say there is a dog or plant, how they do service for Krishna? Because okay, let's example the next birth I born as a dog in my next birth.How I service to Krishna? Because I don't have much intelligence like human being. So what's the plan of God?
他说到生物都可以为 Krishna 做服务，那么如果说狗啊、树木啊怎么对 Krishna 做服务，或者说我如果下一次变成狗，我的智力没有人类那么高，我怎么知道要服务 Krishna？
Well, the dogs, their business is eating and sleeping and mating and defending.
狗呢，一般它的活动就是吃啊、睡啊、交配啊、防卫啊。
So if you have to be a dog in the home of a devotee.
如果你必须成为狗，就在奉献者家里的狗。
So that you can get prasad.
你就可以得到prasad.
But they don't have intelligence, right?
Yeah, but even in the dog's body, although they don't have intelligence, if they get the mercy of a devotee, they'll be benefited in the next life.
即便狗没有那个智力的话，但是由于奉献者的仁慈，这只狗的下意识有这个特别的机会。
That's good. If we got the prasadam after taking the prasadam, we can distribute to the dog.
Oh yeah. Oh yeah.
他说：“那这样子，如果我们自己荣耀prasadam那些多的prasadam，我们是可以去派发给狗的。”
But we're trying to give mercy to the humans first.
但是我们首先试着把仁慈分派给人类。
The dogs come after.
人类先给他们，然后再给狗。
But there are cases of devotees giving mercy to dogs.
当然有这样的实际的例子，奉献者给一些狗啊这些仁慈的。
And the dogs, they get great benefit.From the mercy of the devotee.
那些狗就从奉献者得到很多的仁慈。
Elephants are also, can also be devotees.
那就像大象也是可以成奉献者。
There are temples in South India with many elephants, and some of these elephants are very devoted.
在南印度有一些庙宇里面呢，有大象，那些象也是非常坚定的奉献者。
There was this one elephant, he gave up his body, he came in front of the deities, he gave up his body in front of the deities.
有一只象，他在临终之前自己走到神像面前，然后再断气。
There was one spiritual master, his name was Rasikananda, So he was very powerful. He had some wild animals for his disciples. Even tigers became his
devotees.
As well as some mad elephant.
甚至有那个所谓那一些野外的大象啊，这些生物等等。
So that's the mercy of devotees.
所以那个情况是奉献者的仁慈。
Okay, Hare Krishna.
Hare Krishna.
Jai.
His Grace Narasimha Swami Maharaj ki
Jai!
Radha Lakshmi Mata ji ki
Jai!
Jai!